A man of God that does not understand the New Testament will preach out of guilt. When you preach out of guilt, sick people cannot be healed. Somebody asked me, why don't you flash miracles in your church? Miracles are not a validation of God.
They're not.
That you show miracle doesn't mean God is in your church. Miracles were an afterthought. Because there were no miracles in Genesis. In Genesis, there were no miracles. Everything was perfect. Yeah, Adam and Eve, perfect. Everything perfect. The introduction of miracle is when Moses came before the children of Israel. He said, God, how can I prove to them that you sent me? And he said, put your hand. That was the first time miracle happened in the Bible. It was an afterthought. He brought it out, it was leprosy, put it back, it was okay, throw down your rod, became a snake, take it up. He was preparing him before he was going, because now there was going to be a battle between sign and sign. It was in the Garden of Eden. So it was not part of the original plan in the beginning. So that you're showing miracle in your church does not validate God. Because the same thing you're showing, a native doctor is showing it. The same thing you're showing, a juju priest is showing. There is only one thing that demarcates. Sound doctrine. Sound doctrine. The Lord was working with them, confirming what? So it is the word that becomes the key. When the word is taught, forget miracles. They are natural. Yes, they are natural. They are not things to, we don't follow them. He didn't say believers shall follow signs. He said while believers are going with the word, behind them signs will be happening. So why should I stop going and turn to celebrate what is behind? Any ministry where miracles are celebrated, know that they are distracted. The distraction is that you have left going forward, you have turned to celebrate what is behind you. And Paul said, I forget the past, I press forward towards the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I don't know if I'm talking to somebody. There was never a time in the ministry of Jesus where he brought a miracle and presented. Instead, he will tell them, don't tell anybody, or go and show yourself to the priest. He's on his way, because this guy is too focused to be distracted. And Jesus is the model for ministry. We have people in Power City who were healed of blindness. We have people in Power City who are healed of deafness, dumbness. But my preaching time is too precious to cut out minutes to be sharing testimony, because testimonies don't bring faith. They don't bring faith. Some say, I'm bringing them out so that people can have faith. There is no way you can see miracle and have faith. If miracles bring faith in the ministry of Jesus, everybody will have believed. But the more they saw miracle, the more they didn't believe. The more they didn't believe. Check the ministry of Jesus. Go check it in the Gospels. The more they saw miracles, the more they didn't believe. So emphasis shouldn't be on miracles. Emphasis should be in the world. Yes, Pastor Gift read it yesterday. John did no miracle, but all he said about Jesus was correct. It's there in scripture. And they believed him. The city went to him. He did no miracle. No miracle has the power to save a man. And if you flash miracle, let me tell you, the people you will gather, unbelievers. Because the people that seek for miracles are unbelievers. And if they don't get it, they will dump you and look for where they can get it. So that is not establishing believers. But remember, the fivefold ministry is given for the perfecting of the saints to do the work of the... If I'm speaking, somebody shout, I hear. Please sit down, let's talk. Sit down, let's talk. A sister is here that may testify today, watching me on television. The doctors diagnosed her of cancer. The doctors even gave her up to die. She said she started remembering everything I taught. The word was coming. The word was coming. She looked at the doctor and said, "That thing you want to say, I know better than that." Towards the end of last year or so, she went for final test, or early this year. They said they can't find it. She's here. She flew in from America to attend this conference. I didn't even know. My office told me there's a sister here from the U.S. who came to attend the conference. And I said, "Oh, really? Okay. Good." Then they said she would like to see you. I said, "Okay, cool. I would like to see her." We met. I said, "How did you hear about us?" He said, "I've been watching Kingdom Life Network." "Where is she?" "She's over there." "Yeah." "All the way from Houston." These are not arranged miracles. She's physically here. A brother in our church, 17 years of disease in his fingers. The disease ate his fingers. He couldn't wear shoe. He was coming with bathroom slippers. He was wearing bathroom slippers for 17 years, even when he wears suit. He said, "Last day, when the revelation of Jesus hit me in this church, it was not that they called me out for miracle prayer. The revelation entered me. The fingers got healed and corrected by themselves. I only woke up to discover that the thing is no more there. I didn't even know when it left." He wore his shoe and came to church. He said, "Some doctors here know my story. The thing disappeared without notice." Miracles don't validate God. The validation of God is his word. "In the beginning, and the word, and the word was God." I can go on and on. There are testimonies everywhere. But they are not our focus. Our focus is Christ. They are not our evidence. Our evidence is Christ. The scriptures testify of me, not of my works. The scriptures don't testify of my works. They testify. If we are going to be believers that will manifest Jesus in these end times, we must take their focus from miracle and show them who they are. When a man knows who he is, he doesn't need miracles. Miracle is an emergency for an unbeliever, not for a believer. Yes, it's for unbelievers. If you don't believe me for my preaching, believe me for the things you see. This is for unbelievers. For believers in Christ, when you know who you are, when you see him and see you, in him there can be no sickness. In me there can be no sickness. I had a brother came here on Monday night when I was blowing those things on Monday night. He said the guy stood up and said, "All the problems I brought to this church, I'm dropping it, I'm going. Papa has shown me that me and Jesus, one spirit. The same spirit inside Jesus, not a junior one, the same one inside me. And this body is Jesus's body. The spirit is living inside." He said, "I just dropped everything in the service. I dropped it and went. And it's over." Because the focus is not the miracles. The focus is Christ. When you turn people to miracles, they will leave Christ. Miracles become idols. And miracles don't have the power to generate faith. How does faith come? And hear it? And hear it? And see miracles? How does faith come? By hearing the word. So preach the word. In and out of season, preach it. And the Lord was walking with them, confirming what? He watched over his word to do what? To perform forever, O God. Thy word is settled where? Heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word of God shall abide forever. So shall my word be that goes out of my mouth. It shall not come back void, but accomplish what I please. He uphold all things by the word of his power. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The entrance of his word bring a light and give it understanding to the simple. And the light shines in darkness. Shout fire, somebody. Preach the word. Preach the word. For the time shall come when they shall not endure sound doctrine. Because the only cure for the madness in the body of Christ is sound doctrine. We need some sound doctrine teachers who will not mind popularity and fame, who will see only Jesus and preach the right thing. My brother, let me tell you, all this madness will be swept out. when such men and women rise and stay true to their calling. And stay true to their calling. Not games, not fables. True to their calling. Yeah, stay true to their calling. Not double, not second guessing. True to their calling. He gave gifts to men for the perfecting of the saints to do the work of the ministry. Are we together? Please sit down.